Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Collegiate Star League Vainglory Regular Season Week 5 matchup. My name is Tasty Bacon, and I will be your host and caster for tonight. And we've got ourselves an incredible matchup. It is the final game of the regular season here for Vainglory CSL. And, well, we have two teams that have made it through unbeaten thus far. You can see it there on your screen right now. It is American River College and UC Merced. 5-week season. Each team plays every other team in their division once and has one bye week. And well, including that bye week, both of these teams have gone 4-0 through the first 4 weeks. Well, now something's got to give. Only one of these teams can finish out the regular season unbeaten with a perfect record and go into the playoffs with the number one seed and a first round bye, which is always a great thing to have going into the playoffs. You make it a little bit further without even having to put in the extra effort in the round of six. The loser, however, will be going on, will be taking second place on the season and will be going into the round of six in the playoffs. So there's a lot on the line here tonight. We are going to be wasting no time getting into this one. We're going to take a very brief commercial break, but as soon as we get back, we will be getting right into the game. We've already got all the players in the lobby ready to go, so stick around. Do not go anywhere.
Ben, Sam, and Ken are on separate journeys to defeat the menacing vile dragon. But let's just say luck isn't on their side. If only there was a way for them to find each other and band together. Well, that's why there's Band. It's a mobile app that allows people to come together using common interests. With Band, you can find fellow gamers, chat, schedule gaming sessions, and conduct polls. Stage epic battles with friends while sharing videos and photos along the way. So try Band today. Band. Be together.
All right, here we go, everyone. We are getting on into the draft for game number one of this best of three series. It is, as you can see on your screen, UC Merced on the blue side taking on American River College on the red. For the side of UC Merced, it is Iniesta, Jadel, and Cruz for Cross as their three representatives. And representing American River College, we have, of course, E36 Status and Joker. Well, you may recognize this team as Liberation X. They are a team that has been dominant in the matches that we've seen from them already this season, and they're looking to continue that streak here, but they face their toughest opponent yet in UC Merced, who has also beaten every other team in this division. So as we get into this one, the first ban off the board will be that Kestrel. Lyra is the answer for American River, and we'll see what they decide to pick for the first. It does look like they really want this Vox, and that will be Vox going over to the side of UC Merced. If you've been watching the other CSL matches, you may have remembered UC Merced, we were going to be showing them face off against their UC native and their rival, but that game was unfortunately a forfeit over American River. We've gotten to see them twice now. It's been very convincing performances each time that we have been able to watch them play. So with this Lance and Adagio, it's going to be a pretty strong duo for them to start things off with on this game number one. So what will be the answer? Looks like Taka or Rhyme, perhaps. I would definitely prefer to see the Taka in this situation. That is going to be what they go for. So a solid early game there in the jungle to try and help swing the game in their favor. We'll see if they will have success with that. And finally, for a roamer, there's a lot of options here. They could go for, you know, the Arden, the Catherine. There's the Finn. Flicker is available as well. It looks like they are going to lock in this Arden. Nope, they're not going to lock it in. They're actually going to have a disconnect, so we'll get ours back into the game as soon as we can. And hopefully we can figure out what happened. Looks like it was actually a disconnect, as one of the players has dropped off of the party and off of the game as well. So as soon as we can get them back in, we'll go ahead and get this game going. But while we do wait for that, and it looks like they have gotten back online, so hopefully that will be no longer an issue. We're going to start the draft right back up. And as you can see on your screen now, we are back in the draft and back underway for this one. It's going to be the same pick, same bands up until that final pick for the side of UC Merced. Again, I assume they're just going to stick with the Arden. Yeah, they're going to immediately lock in the Arden. And Saw had been hovered the entire time there for Joker. And they're going to go ahead and lock that in as they keep the heroes exactly where they picked them. That is definitely a always a nice little convenience when you're able to draft in the order that you actually want to play. But we are going to be loading ourselves on to the Halcyon Fold here for game number one in the Battle of the Unbeatens. Only one team can walk out of here with a 5-0 record on the season. And we're about to find out who is going to get the leg up in trying to accomplish that feat. As we load onto the fold right now. There we go. Get everything extra out of there. And we are ready to go. UC Merced taking on the side of American River College. See everyone making their way out of the base. A little bit delayed there for UC Merced, but that's not going to cause any problems. Let's start off with some attack speed on the Taka. Going to be interesting to see how the side of American River actually runs this. Status is going to be playing the Adagio, and Status is their jungler, so it is going to be the carry Adagio with a Roam Lance. Starting with a Weapon Blade means there's going to be a lot of damage on this early game. You can see American River already looking to make the aggressive play. They're going to get spotted there by that flare, but they've already gotten in onto Iniesta. Can they get enough damage down to try and secure a kill? Still waiting for an opportunity there, but because E36 started with the Githian Wall, they actually don't have the opportunity to go for that Impale and try and find the early kill. Instead, they're going to rotate up to the lane, get some nice harassment down. As you can see, pretty much everyone from the side of UC Merced taking a lot of damage, but Joker is actually going to be the first blood. Iniesta able to get in there, get that kill. Nice answer from Status, though, to make it a one-for-one trade. And because both Cruz for Cross and Iniesta are very low, Iniesta, nice job dodging out the Impale, but the Githian Wall is going to hit. This Weapon Blade doing some work for E36. Can he find either of these kills? Everyone is so low. E36 just towing the line between that turret aggro. Status actually taking the opportunity to get some good chip damage onto this turret, but because both Iniesta and Cruz for Cross were taken so low during that skirmish, you can see now, side of American River, they're going to make this quick rotation into the enemy jungle and start farming up these camps. Some heals for E36 to keep him topped off, and also to help Status Pig clear out these jungle minions. And just like that, we've got ourselves a nice little lead for American River. Joker going to have to be a little bit careful here. Here comes Iniesta again, right on to Joker. Joker having to use that roadie run to get himself out to safety, but is able to get out to safety, and that's a key for the Saw. And right now, just gonna be still farming up, taking still some good damage. And Iniesta really wants to make this happen, but the rotation up from American River is going to stop that aggression in his tracks. Cruz for Cross getting hit by that Impale. Nice Githian Wall will knock back three, but is Joker a little too far forward? No, and Iniesta not able to find that kill. Instead, E36 and Status continuing to pump out damage. It will finally be the kill for Jadel, getting the kill with those resonance bounces on this Vox. It's going to be really interesting to see if it does end up being a weapon or a crystal Vox. We can see it is a weapon Saw for American River. That's going to be really interesting. A lot of times when we see the Saw, it does end up being a crystal Saw for that more late game oriented damage. But E36 stealing away a Treant there. Going to be trying to find Iniesta, but not able to connect with that Impale. I'm really curious to see how American River is going to push with this Saw, because if you have a weapon Saw, that just shows you're really trying to end the game as early as you can. E36, oh, nice Impale, going to catch Iniesta. Iniesta should be able to get out of here, though. Githian Wall is going to stun up Cruz for Cross. This Treant doing a lot of work onto E36 as well, but you can see Gonna with status coming in to help out. That's gonna be a back off. Oh, Crucifer Cross tried to help his laner, instead eats the impale and is gonna go down as a result. Status keeping everyone busy. Meanwhile, Joker with this weapon saw. You cannot leave a weapon saw unattended in the lane. He takes down the turret and American River. They are all to the races as they find another kill and steal away more of this jungle. Back up in the lane, Jadel very low, needs to be careful. Joker might want to go aggressive on this one, but with Crucifer Cross there, he's not going to be going diving under the turret or anything. Instead, just opting to put out some damage onto Crucifer Cross. As American River really starting to pull ahead, already a 3,000 gold lead, thanks to the jungle camps they've been able to steal away, and of course that turret going down. That was a very large gold swing going the way of American River. Jadel going to be eating a lot of damage, has to use that Sonic Zoom just to get out of trouble. But is he going to be out of trouble? A status with big damage already, having that alternating current able to do quite a bit. This lane is just going to be under constant siege. Iniesta trying to get the damage onto Joker, but there's that healing coming out from status, keeping him alive. See, just going to be stealing away this jungle some more. There's really not much opportunity for UC Merced to get gold at this point already because of how hard American River is taking over this jungle. The turret is going to be going down. That's two turrets already destroyed 5 minutes into this one. Very quick pace to this game, which is what you expect from a weapon saw. It's got 2,500 gold in the inventory. A suppressing fire will find another kill. Can they get more out of this? Jadel very low is going to be able to survive for now. But that is a big emphasis on the for now. American River, they are on a warpath. Another minion wave pushing in onto this tier 3 turret now. And look at how quickly they take this down so early in the game. We're not even 6 minutes in and 3 turrets have now been destroyed. That's 900 gold per turret going the way of American River. And you can see what that kind of effect that has in the gold difference between the teams. 6,000 gold just about between them at only 6 minutes into this game. American River College is gaining about 1,000 gold per minute more than their opponents. That is a ridiculous pace to be on. We'll see if they can keep it up as they immediately pick up some items. A Sorrow Blade for Joker. That's going to be a big root. And Githian Wall knocks him back. Crucifer Cross should be able to get out of here. Never mind. Status is on the hunt with these basic attacks. Will take down the Arden. And it is just Jadel left. He's going to get rooted and going to drop very, very low. But should be able to escape. One more Sonic Zoom just to get out of harm's way. And you can see how low these death timers are. They just picked up those two kills. They can't even really get onto these turrets before the respawns happen, but they don't really seem to care about the respawns because American River is putting pressure out. Jadel going to be taken low. The impale doesn't hit, and Yesta is going to be trying to take down Joker, but Joker is the one finding a kill as Arden is going to fall once more. They just wait for this next minion wave. Get another shot in before it gets here. That's all they have to do, though, is just keep this pressure on. You can already tell, I mean, they have absolute dominance in this game. The minion's not quite actually going to break that turret barrier, but they find themselves another kill. 7.5 minutes into this one, 8 kills and a 7,000 gold lead. American River College is just really showing that they are absolutely the dominant force in the Collegiate Star League. For Vainglory, is there's going to be a nice gauntlet coming out. We'll get a double stun. Is it going to be enough to find the kills? Jokers goes very low. They will fall, but a nice Verse of Judgment also finds a kill for the side of American River. Crucifer Cross and Jadel both dropping very low, but they get out of there and they have stopped this push at least temporarily, as they are going to be able to have a moment of respite here. But there's still just not really going to be much for them to gain. As a result, they're going to lose out their jungle. The minion mine's going to go over to American River. The gold miner, you'd have to assume, would also be picked up here as it is at a full payout. And there really is just no signs that UC Merced is going to be able to do anything about this. As American River College just is completely dominant in this game. They are really just taking it to them. And well, You see Merced doing what they can to try and push out this lane. E36 gonna be kind of on his own here for now, but Status coming around the corner will get that gift of fire ticking onto multiple members of UC Merced. Fountain of Renewal is gonna come out. It's a little too late, and Jadel is gonna be going down as well. Only Taka gets out alive. We'll see how long that lasts. Taka's gonna at least try and find some gold here in the jungle, but there's nothing there, so he's just gonna have to recall and try and deal with this onslaught that American River College is bringing onto these turrets. Not even waiting for the minions, they're just going straight onto the turret. They take that down, and now they can look for a fight or for the next turret. You can see Joker just says, you know what, I'm just gonna work on this turret. He's gonna get taken down very low, Fountain of Renewal, but he is gonna fall, and it's now up to Status. But Status says, no problem. Finding one kill there, the gauntlet gonna get canceled out by that kill. Both Taka and Vox did get to the safety of the Sanctuary, but for how long? Etsuretsu in, and actually they're gonna be able to find the kill onto Status. E36, last man standing. Joker has respawned though, so there will not be an ace. This is an opportunity for the side of UC Merced to just grab the jungle farm. I really feel like that's what they should be doing. Instead, they're going to try and chase down E36, but it is very difficult to chase a Lance. He's going to be kiting around. Githian wall maybe? Nope, doesn't use it. Does go down, but again, not an ace as the respawns for his teammates did come through. 10 minutes into this one, 12-6. So at least they got a few more kills on the board here for UC Merced, but it is still a massive mountain that they will have to climb to get back into this game. Joker is going to be finding some opposition here. Is not going to be looking to lay down that suppressing fire though, as Status and Joker, they just go to town on this gold miner. They're going to be able to take that one without any issue. 300 gold payout going over to the side of American River. And this time the minion miner was starting to be taken, but it is stopped as Joker shows his face. All it takes is one member of American River to kind of push them back away from any sort of fight. Now E36 is going to find the route onto the Vox. Nice Githian wall to knock him back. The rest of the team wasn't quite able to engage at the speed that they wanted to, but now they can chase them down, force them into that Sanctuary yet again, and just wait for this next wave of minions to come. Getting some good damage down Iniesta. Nice dodge of the Impale, but it doesn't matter. That's a double kill for the Saw. Turret destroyed. Triple kill even on the steps of the Sanctuary. That is an ace. And just 11 and a half minutes into this game, American River College are going to take game number one, looking just as dominant as they have all season long. They are going to be taking that one. Congratulations to American River. Game number one goes over to them, and they are now just one game away from completing the perfect season. This is absolutely incredible, the performances that they've been having all season long. And well, if they can just close it out one more game, they will be the number one seed out of the Western Conference. We're going to go ahead and take a very brief break, but when we get back, we will be jumping right into game number two of this best of three series. Don't go anywhere.
Only
$14.99. Don't miss the call. Download Band. Communication made easy.
All right, welcome back. I told you we weren't going to have long delays, and we are staying true to that word as we are ready to go for game number two. We're going to jump right on into it. The teams have swapped sides, and we are ready to go. Again, it is American River College taking on UC Merced, and American River has the 1-0 lead thus far in this matchup. We'll see if they can close this one out 2-0 and finish the undefeated season. You can see there it is going to be that flicker ban this time around by American River. So we are not going to get to see the newest hero on the fold here tonight, unfortunately. Lance will be the other ban there, as they definitely do not want to deal with E36's Lance, but that is going to leave open the Lyra. You can see E36 very quick to jump on that one. Boy, if that hover comes true, we could have an exciting matchup here. As the Ozo, very, very strong in this latest patch. Got some much-needed buffs that have actually definitely helped him out quite a bit. We'll be up against a Kestrel if they do decide to run it, though. Kestrel can do quite well against the Ozo, but American River College, I'm not sure if they're going to really be... you know, too turned off of going for this composition. If that is the case, we'll see what they decide to lock in here. They got a couple seconds left. Nope, we are going to be getting kicked back out once more. And so we'll see what the deal is there. Hopefully it's another quick fix. We're going to try and jump right back on into this one. And it'll be same picks, same bans again up until that point. Hopefully it's not a continuing issue. But we'll see. We do have those two bans coming out once again. It was the first pick, Lyra. Kestrel. Let's see. There's the second pick. It is Arden for the side of UC Merced. And there's that quick Ozo Adagio picked up by American River. Ozo gonna be incredibly fun to see what they're able to do with that pickup. And the last pick now for UC Merced. Definitely a lot of options, and we'll see what they try and do. Is that Kestrel gonna be lane or jungle? Looks like if they do lock in this Rhyme, it is going to be Rhyme, so looks like it should be the jungle Rhyme with the lane Kestrel. But we are just about ready to get on into the fold for game number two. Prepare. Rosters are set. The champions have been selected. And it is going to be American River College up 1-0 in this best of three. The battle of the unbeatens against UC Merced. And be trying to take home the undefeated season 5-0, not dropping a single game during that undefeated run either. It's been 2-0s all across the board, and they're looking to add another notch in their cap as they are going to be making their way out onto the fold now. And keeping our eyes on this Ozo from status. Again, had some changes in the most recent patch. Made him a lot more durable with those acro bounces and gave him a little bit more movement speed with them as well. So definitely some much needed love for the monkey. They are just going to be clearing out this jungle nice and quickly. It's actually a little bit faster over on the other side of the fold for the side of UC Merced. But you can see once they get to that mid-treant, it does slow down a little bit, and we've got a little bit of a heads-up meeting here in the middle of the map. Level 1 for everyone still, as those shop camps have not been taken. Yesta taking a lot of damage, but so has Status. This Rhyme doing quite a bit of work against the melee Ozo. Looks like they're going to be kind of going their separate ways here. And American River, they're going to be more than happy to just steal away these jungle camps as a reward for their efforts in that 2v2 skirmish. Rotate on up to the lane. Joker doing quite a bit of damage with this carry. Lyra is the Rome Adagio coming out here. Meanwhile, Status going very aggressive into the enemy jungle. I don't think he found anything there, but now he's going to be in a bit of a fight. Does get that heal coming out from the Adagio. The Acro Bounce gets him in range for the first kill of the game. His Treant is still available. However, status, he wants blood, finding that second kill. And now Cruise for Cross going to try and do what he can, but gets taken down underneath this turret. No, he does survive just by the skin of his teeth. However, he did lose out on that Treant. That did go over to status, so going to be a slight gold lead there for the side of American River. And even just looking at the lane, 13-7 in terms of the lane farm. Joker doing a great job up there on this Lyra. Lyra's so good at harassment damage, regardless of if she's in the roam or the carry position. And that's what Jadel has been having to try and deal with up here in the lane. It's definitely going the way of Joker for now, but nice trade. Iniesta's going to be coming in from the jungle as well. The Cruise for Cross is there too, but is obviously a little bit behind, being this Rhyme, very slow-moving hero on the fold, but he's getting some good damage down. Joker eating a couple more Glimmer shots. A third one just for good measure. That Sigil not actually able to heal that much because of the Glimmer shot coming through. So nice job there by Jadel in order to put some pressure on, but unfortunately for side of UC Merce, not able to really find much of anything as a result. Back to status on this Ozo. Rotating on up through. They're going to try and find Jadel. Jadel will get slowed down a bit, but is able to get underneath the turret. And well, that's going to be Iniesta just jumping on over as well. Status trying to go aggressive. Dives into the turret. Takes a little bit of damage for his trouble. Not much really accomplished there. So E36 is going. He's going to get spotted out by that flare. So Cruise for Cross knows that the Adagio is hanging out here. And you can see all of UC Merce rotating a little bit just on the threat that there was going to be a jungle invade. But once they don't see anyone, they immediately back off. Very nice movement there from UC Merce. Much better start off to this game now in the first 4 minutes or so. Of course, it's still not ideal. They are still just a little bit behind, but going again in onto Joker, trying to put pressure down onto this laner of American River. Instead, again, Iniesta takes so much damage in return. When you put E36 and Joker together in this lane, Adagio and Lyra, so much sustain, so much harass. It's very difficult to get much accomplished against them. And so they are going to be trying to get those Glimmer shots down. And a couple of them, again, do hit, but just not enough to really try and get any sort of engagement on. Joker going to get taken down pretty low, gets a heal. Very crucial here from heal from E36. Both E36 and Joker low on energy, so that's going to be a recall. Jadel having a much better game this time around on this Kestrel. Status going to be trying to find some damage here, but he's going to be eating Glimmer shots himself. So again, this Kestrel able to kind of repel the early game aggression that American River has really liked to bring out in these games. Right now, it's going to be Joker having come back to lane, a little bit stronger, still doesn't have that first tier 3 item though, and is going to be getting jumped on. Glimmer shots, not quite enough. Can Cruise Cross get there with the movement speed? Don't think so. That last spire isn't going to work, but the Glimmer shot does. A nice kill picked up by UC Merced, a much needed kill. Now they found status here a bit, getting some good damage down again. Those Glimmer shots really, you know, just bursting opponents down. Status gonna try and turn around. He gets one in return, but does fall. However, there's no jungle here to be stolen, so not really going to be a much gold change as a result of that kill, of those kills, I should say. The one for one here in the jungle is, it allows Joker time to free farm this lane and get it pushed in. You can look at the size of this minion wave that's about to go under the turret. So that's going to be a good number of minions lost here by Jadel to this turret. You see, is going to be a little bit delayed in getting back to the lane as well by E36 running some interference. So a good job there by American River. Just playing the small things, but it's still a very even gold game now. 6 minutes in. I mean, keep in mind, at this point in game number one, American River was 6,000 gold ahead. And this time it's dead even. So you see Merced definitely learning from some of their mistakes in game one and playing much better here in game number two. We'll see if they can keep it up though, because that is the real difficult task against American River College, is, you know, playing well and well enough to stay even, if not have a lead throughout the entire game. More glimmer shots, a nice gank from the jungle, and that is going to be a kill secured for UC Merced. One shot, one kill was used, wasn't necessary, came out a little bit late, but that's going to be Status trying to make the engagement, but doesn't really find much. Verse of Judgment does come out, gets a double stun. Status trying to do some damage on to Cruise for Cross, but Cruise for Cross very tanky on this Rhyme, a lot of survivability, especially with that Eve of Harvest being the first item. It's going to be tough to actually take down the Rhyme in those kinds of situations. However, that's not for a lack of trying, as Status is deep in the enemy jungle trying to find that kill. Isn't going to be successful just yet. Instead, Iniesta might be the target now, as E36 has rotated on over as well. But nope, no one going to die except for Jadel up in the lane. So it looks like there's so much pressure being put into the jungle trying to find a kill. You're very close to the Joker while having very low health. Iniesta does get the gauntlet down. I don't think that was exactly the placement that Iniesta was looking for underneath that turret, but E36 going to eat that one shot. Iniesta still very low. Portal forward. Bright Bulwark down. Lots of damage onto Iniesta, but the Arden is tanky enough to live, and the turret will actually take down Joker. Now E36 going to be on the run. Should be able to get away from this Rhyme, even with that root. Rhyme does not want to go diving underneath the turret. But four kills apiece now at the 8.5 minute mark. Very much better, much stronger showing from UC Merced here. They're going to get a lot of damage on this turret. Kestrel has that Sorrowblade completed. You can see just how much work those glimmer shots do. Status and try and clear out some of these minions, but not before this turret does go down. It's going to be the Bangarang being used. Nice block from Jadel, but is it enough? It is not. It's E36 rotates over, finds that kill. Diving underneath the turret, they've been focusing so hard on trying to take down Iniesta. A lot of times they've actually ended up paying for it as a result. The turret is very low, however. And so American River, once they get this mini wave pushed in, you gotta figure they're gonna maybe look for that turret takedown. Iniesta, again, very low, but not going down. The turret does get targeting onto the side of American River, and they have to back out of here once again. Successful turret defense for the side of UC Merced. And Joker, oh my goodness, those glimmer shots. Portal's not going to be in time. Here comes E36 and Status. Status is jumping on in with those acro bounce, but not getting any of the additional bounces, means he's not going to get that much fortified health. Found of Renewal coming out for E36 to try and save Status, but these glimmer shots, one shot, one kill, will find the kill. And all of a sudden, UC Merced has American River on the ropes. They are really coming at them with everything that they have. A great job here in game number two to have a much stronger showing. They're going to grab themselves that immense gold payout, 300 gold each. Going to be going on over to UC Merced. And can they make anything happen with this? You look at the items, and again, it is very even as far as items are concerned, as it's a little over 1,000 gold lead now for the side of UC Merced. But you look at the jungle, that's the big one that I want to be looking at, as it, again, for Status, a Serpent's Mask and a Breaking Point. He's going to be looking for that heavy survivability, but heavy, you know, endurance fights, trying to get those Breaking Point stacks up, as Joker gets a nice influx of gold off of those minions. Is Iniesta going to get slowed down quite a bit, but has a target to use that Vanguard on. The Gauntlet is used. It doesn't save him, but it will get a kill on the Status pick, because he has nowhere to go. Meanwhile, Jadel able to find a kill to go. Impressive here. It is just E36 left. Cruise for Cross going to try and make this chase. It's a Spire. Gets a Root as a result. Where is the Kestrel? Kestrel is nowhere to be found on my map. Because Jadel actually got killed. I did not notice that one, actually. That was completely my fault. But I'm not sure what happened to Jadel. Last I saw, Jadel was actually pretty healthy, but did end up going down to something. Oh, was it a scout trap? I'll have to take a look at this one a little later. That was definitely a nice fight for the side of UC Merced. Able to get themselves a few kills, and now they're going to get some good farm as a result. And Yesta taking a lot of damage, though. Here comes Cruise Cross diving right onto Joker. Glimmer shots, and that's going to be a quick kill. Joker is just very squishy, has no shield to deal with this Rhyme, and he's trying to build a little bit of armor to deal with this Kestrel. Status going to be found here as well. Are they going to get the slow? Status is going to be trying to make the move back over to E36. Nice burst of judgment means they're going to get one kill. Status is so hard to take down now with that Serpent's Mask and the healing. It's a double kill thanks to the Three Ring Circus. Can they find Cruise for Cross? Rhyme is so difficult to chase onto and try and take down. He's got plenty of fortified health. Is he going to go underneath this turret? That turret's still very low, but there just hasn't been an opportunity for American River to take it down. And, well, that's a, I'd have to say, successful fight for the side of American River. They're able to find a couple kills down in the jungle. We'll see what's going to be going on here. Turret is going to get destroyed while that is happening, but Status stealing away some more of this jungle of UC Merced. 9-9 are the kills, but with that turret going down, that's going to be the gold getting evened up once more. A nice chunk of damage from this UC Merced, and they look for the fight. E36 is going to go right out into the front lines, but they turn their target onto Status Pick. One shot does not connect, and instead it is Cruise for Cross, the one getting taken down very low. Glimmer Shot's trying to do work here, but Cruise for Cross staying alive a long time. Isn't going to be enough of a delay, though. Status Pick with that to charge forward. They do get the kill onto Joker, but that's the only one they're going to get. And Yesta is trying to put some distance between him and the members of American River with that gauntlet. He's going to get collapsed upon, though. Nice acro bounce from Status in order to get onto his target. And that will be an ace at the 13 minute and 40 second mark for the side of American River. 12 to 10 on the kills. But now they can get a really strong push onto this turret with these ace buff minions. Cruiser Cross going to do what he can to stop that. And he's going to be able to take out these minions rather quickly with this Rhyme. So the turret loses about half its health. And Jadel actually steals away that Treant from Status, who's trying to, well, steal it from the side of UC Merced. Does pick up the mid, so at least we'll get a little bit off of this. However, they are still very much on the retreat, trying to lead these members of UC Merced into Joker. Bangarang goes out, doesn't catch anything. A nice job stopping the Aversive Judgment. Joker gets taken down low. Cruiser Cross is on the hunt, but everyone takes those portals through. Joker's going to use that Bright Bulwark to get the slow. Is this going to be a turn from American River? Oh, Cruise for Cross wanted to take those portals, but did not get in them in time. And that is going to be Arden going down in Yesta, giving up another kill. It's just Cruise for Cross left. They're going to be trying to chase this Rhyme down, but I mentioned already it is very difficult to chase onto the Rhyme. And they're going to give that chase up in the end. Again, jungle going to be taken here. Gold Miner going over to American River, showing that they are ready to try and push into this lane. Get some damage on the turrets. Maybe open up an opportunity to go for this Kraken. As Kraken has, in fact, spawned 15 minutes, 20 seconds in. So the objective is there. Is American River going to go for this, or will UC Merced be able to answer if they do? However, there's going to be a Bangarang. Does not connect, but it gets Status right on into the thick of things. Jadel taking so much damage. Gets underneath the turret, though. Nice stun. And Status going to get taken down very low from that turret. And beautiful Valkyrie, but can they capitalize? They are going to lose out on one. The Glimmer Shots, again, just not quite able to take down Joker. Joker's going to put down that Sigil and start healing. Cruiser Cross is the target. The Acro Bounce getting onto Jadel. Jadel falls. Three Ring Circus will help to solidify that kill. And it is an ace for American River College. A beautiful fight. This is going to be two turrets going down for them, as they are going to just continue pushing on, see how much more they can take. For now, it looks like actually they are going to back off, as they realize that the respawns are going to be coming through momentarily, and those minions were not going to be super healthy. So just like that, American River is able to gain the advantage once again. A big gold lead going their way. It is about a 4,000 to 5,000 actually, lead for the side of American River. Again, if they can win this one, if they can close it out, they will complete an undefeated season here in the inaugural season of Vainglory Collegiate Star League. Well, that is what they're looking to do. They're going to actually start off the Kraken. They got Iniesta down to about half health and say, okay, you want to come try and fight this. You're going to be at a severe disadvantage. Even look at the infusions. There's two infusions running for the side of American River. Both of them are going to be running out fairly shortly, so you'd expect to see them try and top those off. But Iniesta looking to engage on the Joker. Rest of the team not really quite able to do so. And that gauntlet being on cooldown for so long means that they're not going to be able to find a fight. So American River just going to go engaging. There's war treads used. Bangarang not going to hit the mark here, but it doesn't really matter. Iniesta is taking so much damage. Fountain Renewal has been used. Is Iniesta going to get out? Valkyrie and the slows from the side of UC Merced will allow the Roamer to get to safety. It was very important to not lose Iniesta in that trade. And instead, they're going to be able to push American River away. American River going to be happy to just grab themselves this jungle farm. Take the minion miner again, but here comes the side of UC Merced. Are they looking for a fight, or do they just want to take what they can from this jungle? Well, what they can is not going to be much, as that Treant gets stolen away by E36. And we are back to where we were about a minute or two ago, with Kraken still being available, but neither team quite ready to commit to it. As obviously American River, they want to commit to it, but they need to be ready for a fight. That's going to be Bright Bulwark with the portals, and a lot of damage getting done, but a beautiful stun will knock E36 out of that Verse of Judgment. And just like that, Joker has gone down. Where is Status? He's nowhere to be found in this. Will try and get in onto Jadel, but does he have enough for the kill? E36 is trying to deal with Cruise for Cross. Jadel is going to get an active camo down. Hits the stun on the Status Bank. Fountain of Renewal from E36 to keep Status alive. Status is going to be staying alive through this. E36 gets the kill onto Jadel, and look at how difficult it is to take down this Ozo. Status with another kill onto Iniesta, and it is just Cruise for Cross left standing. Are they going to try and chase this one down? I don't think they have the ability to get the kill before Cruise for Cross can get to that Sanctuary. No, they don't. They do realize this and back off with 15 seconds till Jadel is up. I would really love to see them go for this Kraken, but I feel like they may have just taken a little bit too much time as they go ahead and start up these jungle camps. However, actually back at the Kraken pit, we do see Joker starting this one off solo. Is that Lyra? So is going to have that healing, that sigil to put down if she takes too much damage from the Kraken. Now the rest of the team is getting involved. Stormcrown for E36 means that this Kraken is going to go down extremely quickly. You can see already almost captured. That will be Kraken unleashed by American River College as they look to end this game out and finish off this series and the season without a loss. It's going to be a Bright Bulwark. Ozo, oh, he gets trolled by the portal, but still able to get onto Jadel. Jadel trying to put down that active camo field, but it doesn't get the stun. Status is already through. Status taking a lot of damage, though. E36 and Joker will find the kill over the wall. Slows onto Iniesta, and there's going to be a movement speed increase as they try and chase down to this one. They don't have those war treads available to finish off this chase, but they're going to just keep using that sigil for the movement speed increase. Iniesta is going to get to the Sanctuary, but Kraken now onto these turrets. And with a Storm Crown on the Adagio, these turrets should go down very, very quickly. You see first one already dead. Kraken still extremely healthy. Second turret is going to be the target. E36 is tanking up the turret as they force Cruise Cross and Iniesta back into the Sanctuary. They aren't able to find the kills, but they're able to take down these turrets. Now they are going to finally have that fight and find the kill onto Cruise for Cross. As the Orion just not able to pull it off here. And that's going to be another kill. Jadel respawned and immediately gets taken out again. Joker did fall, but it doesn't matter. Kraken far, far, far too healthy. And American River College complete the 2-0 sweep, complete the 5-0 season. And an incredible, incredible season from them. 10-0 on the individual games. Just really showing their dominance here in the collegiate scene. They are going to be able to walk away from the regular season with an undefeated record intact, the number one seed from their division, and that means that they will have a first round bye in the playoffs. Unfortunately for the side of UC Merced, they were not able to complete the undefeated season. They go 4-1. However, they are still very much in the playoffs. They will be playing in the first round, however, as they do not get the same luxury of a first round bye that American River has. But, well, congratulations again, American River College, Status, Joker, and E36 on the undefeated season. That's going to do it for us here at the Collegiate Star League Vainglory Week 5 broadcast. That was our final game of the regular season. The standings are now finalized. Once they get updated with this game put in, we know all the teams that are going to be in the playoffs coming out of the Western Division. It is going to be Liberation X with that first round bye, as we mentioned. CP Gang, which is UC Merced, who we also just saw. And then Seattle Pacific University for the Vein, also making it out of the division. Meanwhile, on the other side, in the East, it is University of Florida Scorching Forest taking home an undefeated season over there as well, and getting that first round bye in the playoffs. The other two Eastern representatives are RPI, Rensselaer Polytechnic Institute team, with a 4-1 record. And then it is University of Missouri, Kansas City, Rise of Warriors, also making it out of, or sorry, no, my apologies, those teams were tied, and it was actually Louisiana Tech University, I believe, that made it out of that tiebreaker with the head-to-head record. Never Lay in Khmer's. Their team name is very strange. But either way, those are your six teams that will be competing in the Collegiate Star League Vainglory playoffs. And those are going to be starting up very, very shortly. Keep an eye on the Collegiate Star League website, cstarleague.com, or the Collegiate Star League Twitter. It's at cstarleague, or the Vainglory specific Twitter at cslvainglory. Make sure you keep an eye on all those social media accounts to know when the playoffs are going to happen. I will be doing my best to bring you all of that playoff coverage. But we also want to take a moment to say a quick thank you to the sponsors of the CSL. Of course, Band, as we would not be here without Band. They have been a great help to the CSL. And Twitch.tv. Without Twitch, the CSL would be nothing of what it is today without all their help. So thank you everyone for tuning in. It really does mean a lot to us here. And if you want to help support CSL, again, follow the social media accounts, follow the stream. Also check out the other C-Star League stream. It is just twitch.tv/C-Star League. They broadcast League of Legends. There's Dota, CSGO, all sorts of other collegiate esports happening here in the CSL. It's not just Vainglory. Check it all out. It's a lot of fun. And if you are a collegiate player, if you are in college, grab some of your friends, head on over to cstarleague.com and sign up for the next season, which will be kicking off after winter break. Lots of opportunities for college players here at CSL. Thank you again for tuning in. Hope you all have a great night.